became the intercept, or even intercept anymore, became the point 1, 1. That looks good. That looks good. And sir, I just now noticed, make sure that you label your asymptote so that you said you moved it to left. So that'll be x equals -2. And then there's the point -1, 0, you get labeled that good. Good. Okay, who did this one?
I did. I meant to put x equals 1, by the way. On the asymptote.
Oh, yeah, it should be x equals 1, yeah. Okay, now it is.
I translated right 1 and then I reflected over the x-axis.
Upside down. So the normal shape is this. So when you turn it upside down, it becomes this. Does everybody see that? So would you agree with his picture? Yeah. Now, I know we're just doing casual sketches and it's hard on the board, but we do want to make sure, you see this line right here? This arrow thing right here? What is it doing? It is actually getting closer to the asymptote, right? So we want to make sure that there's no like arcing out. It's not a huge deal, but you know, it is approaching its asymptote. All right, what was this one? Log negative x? All right, who did that one? What's your thought on that?
I just reflected everything across the y-axis.
Because that's what happens when you change the sign on x, right? So instead of having this shape, he had the mirror shape this way, right? So instead of having the point, well, nobody's got it. Instead of having the point 1, 0, he had -1, 0. Beautiful. And when it's an axis, you don't usually need to label it, but I don't know, x equals 0. Good job. All right, does anybody have a question about those, Tyler?
Is there not a difference when it's between, like, on the graph, what's that, and log?
No. Now, if we were plotting, like, random points, yes, there would be a difference. Because when you plot the points, like, when we looked at y equals 2 to the x and y equals 3 to the x, these have exactly the same shape, but they contain different points. If you put 1 in here, you get 2 on this graph, but on this one, you get 3. So they have different steepnesses, you know, they're different steepness, but the shape is the same, and we're just drawing the basic shape. So yes, any logarithm is going to have this shape, no matter what the base is. Just like always, those rules aren't different. Okay? All right, now this next one is wild and wacky. I'm going to try to avoid this wackiness. What I want you to do is type it into your calculator if you would. Just use a standard window. I want you to look at it and try to figure out what in the world happened. Are there parts of it that make sense to you?
Does it just get too close to the asymptote to grab?
What?
Does it just get too close to the asymptote to
grab? Oh, okay.
Yeah. No, it keeps going.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, not that part. That's not what I'm talking about. First of all, does the fact that it resembles just in kind of general shape, this one makes sense to you? Because if you look at, what is it, 3 minus x? That's the same as... Would you agree with that? So, it makes sense that because of this negative, it's going to have this shape, a or I mean, it's going to be sort of situated like this. That makes sense. Okay. Finally, zero. Find the zero for that function.
X equals 2.
That's interesting. There's no keys in the problem, but let's see if we can figure out what's going on. So, where's the what would it look like? So I guess the asymptote's 3. And it looks like this, right? Okay. So basically we get the flip, we got that. This is going to move it, or we would think this would move it 3 to the right. So that happened, I guess. What makes this problem odd to me is that what if we did those two things in the other order? What if we translated it 3 to the right first? So we get 3. And then we reflected it across the y-axis. Now, as long as if we try to reflect across the y-axis, it's going to be clear over here, right? But what if we just reflect across the translated axis? Then would it work out okay for me?
Yeah.
Okay, so I want you to make a little note of that. That's a little wild and wacky. We're used to thinking about translating this negative, translating across the y-axis. But if you have already translated the axis, then you're going to rotate across that axis, not the y-axis.
Do you always have to factor out a negative if it's on the x?
That's standard procedure, really, in any other function. We'll do that in trigonometry also. We won't be doing, I guess, there's no asymptotes in sines and cosines.
So, like, with exponents, you're going to, it goes up like this.
Mm-hmm.
It would be the same thing. Like, you moved up the asymptote,
yep.
You're just flipping
it
down. Oh.
Yep, perfect. Perfect analogy. If you have moved your axis, then that gives you a rotation. Okay. Beautiful. Beautifully done. You guys are awesome. All right, let's try do a word problem here. We've already done some of these, so we're ahead of the game. So let's see if you can manage a problem or two. Oh, this is going to be a logarithmic regression model. Okay. What are we going to put into our calculator in terms of x's and y's? Years since 1970? Yeah. We decided yesterday that was probably the best way to do it. Anybody with an old calculator like mine, remember how to clear your list out? If you still have that big list from yesterday, you can't have all that in there.
Would it be a natural logistic?
Oh, not logistic. LN, natural, or whatever it says. I haven't gotten that far yet, so I don't think you need it. Don't worry about graphing this. That window would be crazy. Don't worry about it. We know we're doing logarithmic regression. There I'm talking. logistic.
Can't you not use zero because it's a logarithm?
Why does this keep happening?
Miss Ford.
Pardon me? What else?
Can you not use zero because it's a logarithm?
I'm gonna check that. What happened? I just screwed up my numbers.
You
got an error message?
Yeah.
Okay. Take out that data point and see if that fixes it, or change that data point. How are we gonna change them then?
Make them the years.
Since 1960? Sure. We just gotta remember that when we answer our question.
Yeah, we're just here.
Well, oh, you didn't?
No.
If you put in, I put in 1970.
I put in the actual years.
Oh, yeah, so you got, so you probably got a different
data. I got negative.
Yeah, you got a very different
So we're not machine?
Well, no, let's see what happens when you answer the question. This is really not the equation we're interested in. Now, yesterday we were having all kinds of trouble even getting an equation with the numbers you're putting in. Alright, what'd you come up with? I am still typing in numbers for like the third time. Now, whatever equation you came up with, I want you then to figure out, to use it to predict when the population will be 1,500,000. So we're going to have several different equations because we're entering in several different pay attention to the way your equation is structured. It's A plus B ln X. Does everybody notice that? Okay, that's the way the calculator does it. A plus B ln X. So we're putting in 1,500,000. Alright, let's get an equation up here. It may not be your equation. Who got a good equation, you think? Or an equation?
Could not. 24,646,000. Oh, no, sorry. My comma's off. 246,461,780.3. plus 32,573,678.5.
So you would put them in, or the 15,500,000 over here, right? Alright, so then what did you do?
I got -2,000,000.
This is
negative. So I added over the 246 million, and then got 200.7.
Okay. So you added this over here. Perfect. Yep.
Then divided that number. And then you got 0.7612.
Okay. So I got 7.6123384 equal to LNX. Is that what you have? I may have typed in a digit for 3257.
You really got the same number, maybe a zero off somewhere, or a comma off somewhere.
Alright, we'll do it again and see. Okay, all these numbers right here, I have written down up here. Okay, would everybody type this in? We're using Sir's equation, but we gotta get moving on. So, and I can't find a mistake in mine, and he can't find a mistake in hers, in his. So I need somebody else to, yeah, so. Don't just sit there and laugh. Come on, we're trying to figure this out. We're not gonna solve it graphically. I hear somebody whining about that. Nope, that's not what we're doing. We're solving it algebraically. So, solve that equation. That probably isn't your equation. Solve it anyway. And then we'll compare his answer to your answer once we figure out what this decimal is right here. So we're adding this to the other side and we're dividing by that. What did you come up with?
2021.
What?
2022.
No. What did you come up with right here? That's where we're not having an agreement. 7 point? Okay. So we're good with 7.6. Now, how do we solve it from here? What are we doing? We're going to, remember there's an E there, and we're going to raise E to this power. And that should give us, now, let's talk about what that gives us. That's going to give us a pretty big number. So, Drew, I think you said, actually, it's almost 202. Now, Sir's answer came out to be the exact year. Because when he built his table, when he put his data in, he used the years. If you didn't, if you used some other kind of way to classify the years, then you didn't get 2023 when you worked it out. But when you adjusted it, did you? Or not? No?
I got 2098. I did.
2098?
Yeah.
I did.
That's when, if you do it 10 years before, is the, like, years since 1960. If you plug into those products.
So it doesn't work to change the years. Why did it work with the exponentials, but it didn't work with the logarithms?
Maybe because they're less correlated. Like this one's correlated like 0.1, and those ones are correlated at like almost 1 flat. Like they were born. Maybe it has something to do with that.
I don't know. I'm gonna have to ponder that. So we need to make a note. We need to make a note. I had no idea that wasn't gonna work. We need to make a note that when we're entering logarithmic data, we have to enter exact data. What's so frustrating is when you entered exact data yesterday. I don't know. Someone smart out there figure this out. But do make a note because it didn't work. Obviously, 2098 is not the right answer. So it didn't work. I gotta talk to someone to figure out why that is. But anyhow, move on. Here we go. Match the function with the graph. Okay. Think about that. Which one goes with what? I like to do the easy ones first. That's an easy one. Sir says log 1 minus x goes with b. That's his guess, okay?
No.
D as a dog. D as a dog, okay. All right. Anybody have any thoughts on the rest of them? Or you want to change that one?
Two
is B. That's the easiest one, I think. Two is B. What's this one? It's going to be upside down. Okay. So what's left is C. It's going to work.
Yep.
And it's going to rotate over 4, but then back up. Alright, now we're moving on to 3-4. So 3-3 homework will be due on Friday. Come look at these properties, and then if we have a homework question, we can talk about that too. Go into the properties now. They're all listed there. You've seen them before. We're not going over them. We're going straight to the problems. We'll talk about the properties as we use them. When you take the logarithm of a product, this is a product, this is a multiply, you can separate that into the sum of the logarithms. So instead of having one logarithm, we're going to split it into two, and because the original numbers are being multiplied, we're going to make it a sum. What's the log of 100? 2? There's your answer. Another property of logarithm says, and this is the one we use, when you take the logarithm of something to a power, you may pull the power out in front. So one of our properties says you can break apart a product into a sum. Another property says when you take the logarithm of something to a power, the power comes out in front. Remember, we're not solving these, we're just rewriting them. This is a quotient. So it works exactly like the product, except when you split it up, it doesn't split into a sum, it splits into a difference. So this is going to be the log of 2 minus the log of 1. So in a nutshell, there are your three properties. Those sounding vaguely familiar? We need them to solve equations. Alright, so now we have ln 43x over 1, a little more complicated. What is your thought on this?
So, just the radical is essentially a power of 1/4. Take that out and put it in the front.
Well, wait, one step at a time. And you can do that. I'm going to show every step. So, as Bronson said, the 4th root is a 1/4 power. And then he said, okay, it's a power. And when I take the logarithm of something to a power, the power can come out in front. Perfect. Okay? You're not done. This is a quotient, right? So what happens to that? It breaks down into ln x minus ln y. Quotients are pulled apart into subtractions. Products are pulled apart as additions. Tyler?
Is it okay if you wrote like 1/4 ln x minus 1/4?
Yep. Now, those of you that are good at this, you can go probably to the answer in one step. But let's do it in stages to make sure everybody's keeping up. So what's going on in this problem? Well, it's all multiplied, right? So let's start by pulling apart those multiplications. So we're going to have log of 10. We're going to have a log of x squared, we're going to have a log of y to the 4th. Step 1. What about log 10?
1.
What happens here?
2
log x. And what happens here?
4 log y.
Beautiful. That's totally expanded. Your directions were to expand it. It's completely and totally expanded. All right, one more and we're done. So ln x squared plus
5.
Okay, so we can think of that numerator as x squared plus 5 to the 1/2. You gotta be careful here. So you're going wild and wacky. Yep. Somebody eating crazy weenies for breakfast. No. Sorry, I know you're tired. Alright. First things first. This is a difference. Alright, it's a quotient. So it's gonna be a difference. So I'm gonna start with that. Then the 1/2 can come out in front. And then we are done. Ln log does not distribute. It's not a number. This is not a number. It is a fraction, but that doesn't distribute. So that parentheses just means that's good. Why did I not bring the 1/2 out the front at this point? Exactly. It only goes with the numerator. So that's why I split it first and then pulled off the 1/2. All right.